On 11th May 2021, a 13-story building in Tel Aviv was hit by a rocket fired from Gaza. The Israeli military said that this missile had a range of 120 kilometers. But how did Hamas, which so far fired crude homemade rockets, acquire such a long-range missile? And how did Israel's Iron Dome not intercept it? What weakness of the much-hyped Iron Dome was exploited by the Hamas? Before we answer that, let's understand how Israel designed the Iron Dome and from where they got the funding. The Iron Dome has three central components. The detection and tracking radar. This is built by Elta, an Israeli defense company. Battle Management and Weapons Control, or BMC, is built by Empress Systems, an Israeli software company. Missile launches. This unit launches the Tamir interceptor missile. A typical Iron Dome battery has 3 to 4 launchers, 20 missiles per launcher. This setup is called a battery and it costs $50 million per battery. And each interceptor missile cost about $40,000. But it's still cheaper than the Patriot missile system, which cost about $1 billion per battery. The Patriot missile system is the standard of the IDF. But in spite of the reduced cost, Israel could not afford the Iron Dome systems. Thanks to this man, the American President Barack Obama, who in May 2010 moved a resolution in the US Congress for a $205 million aid to Israel. It was passed 410-4 in the US House of Representatives. Presently, there are 10 batteries manufactured and deployed. For Israel, the Iron Dome-like defense system is vital for its survival. During the 2006 Second Lebanon War, approximately 4,000 Hezbollah-fired rockets landed in northern Israel, including in Haifa, the country's third-largest city. The rocket barrage killed 44 Israeli civilians and caused some 250,000 Israeli citizens to evacuate. Life is precious. Israel has a population of just 10 million, just one-tenth of the population of India. In 2007, Israel commissioned the development of Iron Dome, choosing Israeli contractor Rafael over American giant Lockheed Martin. But Rafael had to develop the weapon from scratch, as there was nothing like it in the entire world in terms of speed, capabilities and accuracies. The Iron Dome went from the drawing board to combat readiness within less than 4 years. The Iron Dome is developed to protect the Israeli population from rocket fire from the neighboring Gaza. The Hamas militants in Gaza have a stockpile of cheaply made rockets called the Qassam rockets. The Qassam rockets varies from a length of 180 cm to 244 cm. Its warhead consists of TNT and urea nitrate, which is a fertilizer, and its mass varies from 5 to 10 kg. It uses a solid fuel, which is a mixture of sugar and potassium nitrate. The first Qassam rocket was fired in 2001 and had a range of 3 kilometers. But Hamas, with the help from Iran, had improvised. On May 11, 2021, the Hamas fired a rocket called A-120, which hit Jerusalem. Now all parts of Israel comes under the Hamas rocket threat. The Iron Dome became operational on 27th March 2011. It has a success rate of 90%, which is very high compared to other defense systems in the world. Every weapon system has a weakness which the enemy has to detect and exploit. So the Iron Dome also has many weaknesses. The Hamas fires a rocket which costs $1,000, and this rocket is intercepted by a rocket costing $40,000 from the Iron Dome. If the Hamas is to fire the inventory of 100,000 rockets, this would bankrupt Israel. There is only a limited number of targets that the Iron Dome can engage at a time. This is the most important weakness that the Hamas exploits. Today, the Hamas fires continuously to overwhelm the Iron Dome system. In the latest conflict, Hamas was able to fire more rockets in tighter groups and what we call as salvos. In one salvo, Hamas fired 137 rockets in 5 minutes. Iran had supplied Hamas with rockets and technical aid, but the militants are starting to build rockets on their own, using parts scavenged from recovered Israeli missiles and common items such as water pipes. To overcome the weakness of the Iron Dome with respect to its cost, the IDF has now been focusing on directed energy weapons which has lower cost per shot. Several low-power solid-state laser beams of power levels ranging from 10 to 40 kilowatt could coordinate and converge on one spot to destroy a rocket safely from 15 to 20 kilometers away. But laser beams become distorted and ineffective in foggy or heavy cloud conditions. Hence, to make an all-weather defense system, these laser weapons will have to be used in conjunction with the Iron Dome. Hence, the Iron Dome defense for the time being will stay and continue to defend Israel till a suitable replacement is found. Please comment on what you think about this video. And thanks for watching.